This conference will now be recorded.
Yes, Biswas.
Yes, yes.
So till now we discussed about what are different CMSs available in the market, what is CMS, why AEM is in demand. Then we discussed different instances of AEM, like author instance, published instance. We discussed dispatchers. We discussed templates, components. Okay. Then we discussed about different consoles available in AEM. Particularly, we discussed CRXD console, site admin console, DAM admin console. And in CRXD console, we have seen the folders, apps folder, content DAM folder. Okay, so all those things we have discussed. Right. So now we are going to discuss other consoles of AEM. So right now I open site admin console. In the site admin console, there is a green color toolbar, and you will find multiple icons. So we have seen this site admin, we have seen this DAM admin also. So now we are going to discuss the rest of the consoles. So this console is called as MCM admin console or campaign admin console. Using this console, you can manage the campaigns. So in Adobe Marketing Cloud, like AEM, there is one more tool called Adobe Campaign. Okay, if you want to show the ads in your screen, okay, you can create those ads in your Adobe Campaign tool. Okay, and you can show those ads in your on your AEM pages. Okay, once you create your ads or campaigns, all the campaigns will be visible in this ad in this console. Okay, provided your AEM is integrated with Adobe Campaign. And to integrate that, you need to provide the credentials, sandbox credentials. Okay, that integration is not done here, but this is just for your information that this console can be used to manage the campaigns. Okay, when you integrate AEM with Adobe Campaign, you can use those campaigns in your AEM pages using this console. So now go to the next console. This is your inbox. Okay. Inbox means I logged in as admin. I'm the admin state. Okay. So I logged into AEM as admin state. So for the administrator, so these are the pending action items or notifications. So in inbox, I'll be able to see all the pending action items and notifications. So inbox shows the pending action items and notifications of the current user. So when we discuss about the workflows, so that time we'll discuss more on this inbox and we'll do some activities here. Okay. Then we'll go to the next icon. So this is your user admin console. Okay. So using this console, you will be able to manage the users. Okay. Manage the users means you can create the users, you can edit the profile, you can provide different privileges to the users. Okay. So in AEM, we have different types of users. Like we already discussed, we can have developers, we can have content authors, administrators, QA people or testers. We have different types of users in AEM. Okay. So using this console, you can create different types of users. Let's say I want to create one content author. Okay. So what shall I do? So using this console, user admin console, I can create one content author. So how to create it? So here you will find one edit button. Beside the edit button, there is a drop down. Click on that. Click on create user. I'm going to create a user and that user is a content author. Okay. So click on create user. So in the login ID, I have to provide the whatever login ID I want to keep. I just need to provide that. Let's say so any last name, email ID, password. Okay, so I'm creating a user. While creating the user, if I want to store the information about the user at a particular place, then I can select that path also. Okay, so I click on this browse button. So here I'll find multiple folders. So let's say I'll select WRETL. I can select any of the folder. Okay, I selected WRETL. It means in this folder, all the information about the user that I'm creating will be stored. Okay, so test batch user. So I created one user. So till now it is not decided whether this user is a developer, QA or content author. So let me first find out that user. You will find a search box here. Here you can type test. Okay. So this is the user I created just now. So double click on it. So here I can see all the information that I entered while creating the user. First name, last name, email. If I want to modify the profile also, I can do here. So here you will find multiple tabs. So there is a tab called groups. Click on this. So it is showing everyone. By default, whenever you create any user, it belongs to everyone. It's a default behavior. Okay. So then there is a tab called permission. So I already created one user and I can see multiple tabs here. When I double click and open that user. So click on permissions. So when I click on permissions, I can see number of folders are here. So when you open CRXD, you will find all the folders there. Okay, so in this is your CRXD console. Here you will find number of folders. Same folders can be visible here. Okay, so I'm creating, let's say I'm creating a content author. Here I have to provide that permission. I need to provide that accesses to that particular user. If I'm creating a content author is going to create your website and its pages. So where your pages will be created in content folder. So here you will find multiple checkboxes. You can provide read access to the content author. You can provide modify access to the content author. Let's say we created some pages and you want to modify some content in that page. So you have to provide modify access. So read, create, modify. So all the checkboxes should be selected for the content author. Okay, for the content folder. I'm creating a content author, and for this content folder, all the checkboxes will be selected. So similarly, the content author should be able to create the dynamic templates. So dynamic templates are created in the conf folder. So in the conf folder, you can see multiple checkboxes also. So you can select all the checkboxes. Okay. So if you are creating a content author, you can select all the checkboxes, conf folder, content folder. What about the apps folder? In apps folder, the developer is going to create templates, components, and all. Okay. So usually content authors are non-technical or some semi-technical persons. Okay. They are not able to do the coding. So in apps folder, we used to create our components. So we used to do some coding in apps folder. If I give create, modify, delete access to the content author for the apps folder, there are chances that he can modify some component, the code of any component, he'll delete it. Okay. So it will break your website. It will break the pages of your website. So better provide only read only access to the apps folder. If you are creating a content author, provide read only access to the apps folder. No other checkboxes will be selected. Here in conf folder, all checkboxes should be selected. Content, all checkboxes should be selected. Then the content author can create some users. So you can select read, modify, delete access to the home folder. Okay, except this, all folders only read only accesses can be given to the content. If I am creating a developer, what all accesses I should provide? So for the apps folder, all the checkboxes should be selected, because I can create a template, I can create component, modify it, create it, delete it. So all the checkboxes should be selected for the developer, for the apps folder. Even if the developer can create dynamic templates and all, so select all the checkboxes for conf folder. And the developer should be able to create the website and its pages to test its templates and component. So provide all the accesses to the content folder. And in etc folder also provide all the access. You can create some client libraries and all. For home page, for home also provide all the accesses. For leaves, only provide read only access, because in leaves all the out of the box things are there. So no one is allowed to do any changes in leaves folder. So only read access. No other checkboxes will be selected. So all other things you can provide only read accesses, and no other checkboxes will be selected. Okay. If I am creating administrator, so you have to select all the checkboxes. You should be able to do everything in your system. Okay, all the checkboxes will be selected. So based on the type of the user, you have to select the checkboxes here in the permission tab. Okay. So based on this, simply by creating a user, you are not creating a content author or developer or tester. So by providing the permissions, you will decide what type of user you are creating. Okay. Apart from that, there is another tab called preferences. So here you can select preferred language, Windows management, and all. So let's say you are creating a content author for your Spanish website. You want to launch your website in English, Spanish, French. Okay, for your Spanish website, you hired a content author. Okay, so while creating that content author in user admin console, you should just give the preferred language is Spanish. Okay, by default, the preferred language is English. If you are creating a content author for your Spanish website or French website, you have to change the preferred language. Instead of English, it should display that preferred language. Okay, so this is about creating the user. So you can create the groups also. Okay, groups means, let's say you are working in a project, there are 15 resources are there in a project. So there are 7 developers, 4 content authors, 3 QA, and 2 administrators. Okay. You can create a group for the developers, create a group for content authors, create a group for administrators. First, you have to create the users, then create the groups, assign the users to the groups. Let's say I want to create a group for the content authors. So how to create the group? Same process. Go to edit drop down, create a group. Let's say okay, you can give any name. Okay, I'm creating a group called test batch authors. Some description you can give, anything. Then you can select a path where you want to store the information about this group. Let's say there are multiple folders, I'll select A. Okay, so test batch group with the ID, group name is test batch authors. I'll create this group. Okay, so where is this group? This one. Double click, this group opens here. Okay. So this is the first name, last name, whatever you entered while creating a big group. Then click on the group tab. So by default, if you create any group, any user, it will belongs to everyone's. Then members. So I created a group. Now in my group, I want to put the members. Let's say I'm creating a group for the content authors. I will put all the content authors as members into the group. Okay. Let's say I created this content author, right? Test batch user, and I want to put this user into the group. So I drag and drop here. Okay. So test batch user now belongs to this. Okay. So I open this group and I drag and drop this user. So I can see the group, see the member here. I can provide group level permissions also. Click on permissions tab. Okay, so I just click on the group, double click on the group, and all the tabs opened. So here I am providing permission to the group. Let's say I am creating a group for the content authors. So I will select all the checkboxes, subconf folder, content folder, select checkboxes, read only for apps folder, then all other read only checkboxes for other folders. Okay, so based on the type of group, I am creating a group for a content authors, developers, administrators, you need to select the checkboxes. Okay. Then when you assign any particular member to this group, whatever checkboxes, whatever permissions you have given to that particular group will be applied to that member. Okay. I created a group for content authors. One new person joined my team. Okay. I created that user and drag and drop it to that. So whatever permissions applicable to that group now is applied to that user. So I can decide group level preferences also. Let's say I'm creating a group for content authors of my Spanish website. Okay, there are three persons who will do the content authoring for my Spanish website. So I created a group and I can select the preferred language as Spanish. Okay, so in this way, you can create the users, create the groups, assign the users to the groups, and you can provide the permissions to the users as well as the groups depending upon the type of user you are creating. So where all the informations are stored in the backend. So go to select the console. So there is a folder called home. Okay, so go to users. So WRETL, if you remember, while creating the user, I have selected WRETL. Means under WRETL, the information about that user is stored. So this is the user that I created. Okay, so all the informations are stored here. So select profile, you can see from first name, last name, email ID and all. Okay, so this is the similarly where the group informations are stored under groups tab. So I selected a folder. So here you can see test batch. Okay, you can see the profile. So this is the group that I created. Okay, so all the users are stored in the home folder. So in apps folder, static templates components will be created. In content folder, our website and its pages will be created. Inside the content folder, we have a DAM folder. Inside the DAM folder, all our digital assets, images, videos, documents are stored. Then in the home folder, all our users are stored. There are some other folders here. So let me open leaves folder. Okay. So in leaves folder, leaf stands for library. So all the out of the box, inbuilt things will be there in leaves folder. So AEM provides some inbuilt components, out of the box components or foundation components. Okay, so you can see all the foundation components in leaves folder. So where can I find the foundation components? So in leaves folder, you'll find a folder called foundation. There is another folder called components inside that. So these are the, let me just this. lips, foundation components. Okay, so you can see all these components are there. So due to some UI issues, so it is not visible, but all the components are there. In all the foundation components are there in leaves foundation components, and all these components are created using JSP. Okay, so inside the leaves foundation components folder, all the components are created using JSP. So these are the foundation component out of the box. So in leaves also, I will find one more folder called WCM. Okay, under WCM foundation components. Okay, so here I can see some more components, foundation components. Okay, so leaves foundation components and leaves WCM foundation components. So these are the two places where we can find all the foundation or out of the box components. Okay, so this is about your leaves folder. So while we'll discuss about inheritance of components and all, we'll discuss more on this. Now go to Okay, are you able to hear me?
Yes, Miss Wa.
Okay. Yes, Miss Wa.
Yes.
Okay. Any questions, doubts till now? So this is all about your user admin console.
Hi, Miss Wa.
Yes.
Yes. I had small doubt. Is this process will be? Is this the initial process while we are creating components and templates?
No. We have not started creating templates and components. We are just discussing about different consoles available in AEM. Okay. So when you install AEM author instance in your system, you will be able to access all the consoles. You should know why these consoles are there, what can you do with those consoles. You should have a good idea about all the consoles. That's what we are discussing. We have not started creating templates and components.
Okay. I had one more doubt. I didn't understand about the term about content authors. What is the role or job will be done by content authors?
Okay, so content authors are the persons who are going to change the content of your website. Okay, so content authors are the persons who are going to create your website. So in AEM we have different types of users. Developers will create templates, components, they will write Java classes, they will do coding, everything. Now once the developer created the templates and components, the content author will use the templates to create the pages of your website. Okay, website and its pages are created by the content author. And in that page, what all content you want to show to the end user? Okay, content author is going to add those contents. Okay, based on your requirement, whatever your customer says, you have to add those content on your pages. So all, and tomorrow your website is showing something, day after or tomorrow your client wants, I want to show some other thing on my website, on my page. So content author is going to do that change. Okay, let me open one website. So I opened ndtv.com. Okay, whenever you open this website, you will find this website up and running. But after 10 minutes, if I refresh this page, I will see some different content here on this page. How the contents got changed? Content author is the person who is changing the content in the background. without restarting the server, they are changing the contents of your website. So developer is not changing the content. Content author is changing the content.
Okay.
Understood?
Okay.
I want to show this image, or I want to show some different text here. Who will do that? Content author is going to write that different text, author that different text.
Okay.
I want to show a different image. Content author going to add that different image here, not the developer. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. So now we'll go to the next console. This is called as tools or MIST admin console. Okay. So this console will be used for multiple purposes. So it is, it doesn't have a specific thing to do. For like your site admin, you can create your website and its pages. DAM admin, manage the digital asset. User admin, managing the users. But MISC admin, you can do a lot of things. There is no, not a specific task that you can do. Okay. For example, let's say you have one author instance and two publish instances running in your local system or in any system. Okay, two publish instances. One publish instance is running on port number 4502. Another publish instance running on port number, sorry, one publish instance running on port 4503 and another publish instance running on port number 7503. You authored something in your author instance, which is running on 4502, and you published it. So by default, it will go to the publish instance running on port number 4503. That is the default mapping. Your, see, now my author instance is running on port number 4502. Okay, you can see localhost colon 4502. Similarly, you can start your publish instance, and your publish instance will run on port number 4503 or 7503 based on the port you provided. Okay. When I publish the content from this instance 4502 author instance, by default it will go to the publish instance running on port number 4503. But you have another instance running on 7503. How you will publish the content from 4502 author instance to 7503 publish instance? So that configuration can be done. So there is one folder called replication. Then under that agents on author, there is a folder called default agent. Double click it. Yes. So here you can see agent is enabled and replicating to localhost colon 4503, means your author instance running on port number 4502 is automatically replicating into publish instance running on 4503. Both are mapped. Now if I want to change that, so there is a edit button, click on edit. So this widget will open. There is a transport tab. Here, the first field, you can change the port number from 74503 to 7503. Now, once you change it and save it, once you, then you publish the content, it will go to publish instance running on port number 7503. Okay, so that, that configuration can be done here using this MISC admin console. In MISC admin console, we have a lot of things. For example, there is a folder called workflow. Double click on this. Okay, this is your workflow console. You can open your workflow console from MISC admin console also. So in this console, you will be able to see all the out of the box workflows. Okay, if you create a new workflow also, you can use this console. You can open any of the workflow and you can see the behavior of that workflow. Okay, this is your workflow console. You can open it from MISC admin console. Okay, so this is about MISC admin. Now go to the next console. This is your tagging console. Using this console, you can create the tags. You can manage the tags. So what is a tag here? So in AEM, we use tags to identify resources. Okay. So I'll give one example. Let's say you are working in a technology park. There are multiple companies are there. Okay. You will find a lot of people moving here and there. How will identify a particular person? So all the people moving inside that technology park are wearing the tags, name tags. By seeing that tag, you can easily identify this person is working for this company. This is the employee ID and this is his name. So the tag helped us to identify that person. So in AEM also, there is something called tags that will help us to identify the resources. When I say resources, it can be an image, digital asset, it can be a page, it can be content fragments, it can be experience fragments. So we'll discuss more on that going forward. Okay. So using this tag management console, we are going to manage the tags. We can create our tag hierarchy. You can associate the tags with the resources. So this is your tag management console. There is one equivalent UI console also available for this tag management. Okay. Fine. So we covered all the consoles, and we have one more console also. Localhost colon 4502/system/console. So this is another console provided by AEM. Okay. Mostly this console used by the developers. Okay. If using this console, you can manage your OSGM bundles. You can install it, you can start it, stop it, delete it, refresh it. Okay. You can monitor whether your bundle is working fine or not, whether it is active or stopped. So using this console, you can do a lot of things. When you start discussing about OSGM methods, we use this console frequently. Okay, so we covered all the consoles. No, one more is there. Master navigation console is there. Localhost colon 4502/AEM/start.htm. AEM/start.htm. So when you start your author instance, usually this console opens. This is your master navigation console. From this console, you can navigate to all other consoles. Okay. Like in the left side, you will find a hammer symbol. Click on that. If you click on this, it will take you to the CRHD console. Okay. Now click this. There is called sites. If you click on this, it will take you sites.html, where you can create your website and display. If you click on asset, it will open your assets.html, which is the equivalent console of YAML. Okay, you can create experience fragments. Okay, so all those things can be found here. This is your master navigation console. You can create dynamic templates, configurations, components. So we covered all the consoles of AEM. So we covered CRXD, site admin, DAM admin, user admin, inbox, then this master navigation console, system console, workflow console. Okay, so just go through all the consoles. We discussed briefly about all the consoles. Going forward, we are going to use those consoles while developing our website. Okay, so actually we have to do the installation in the next class. Okay, so all the people who are enrolled, please, and then who are not enrolled also, just get in touch with Srinivas. Once he share the email IDs, I'll share the installables with those persons, and we'll do the installation in the next class. Okay, any questions, doubts till now?
Bishwa, yeah, Veera here.
Yes, go ahead, please.
Veera here. So yesterday I have missed the class. Okay, today is my first class. So where can
yes,
I get sir. The yesterday's recording?
Yes, Sampath or Srinivas is going to provide that recording. The training organizer. So just get in touch. Just send in. You
okay. Sure, sure. And the second one is just now you have explained about the tagging, right? Tagging. So can you show me one example for that?
I explained about tagging. I explained about the console. What is that console? Tagging console.
Okay.
So tagging will tag one class. So don't worry.
Okay. This is just introduction about the tagging. That's all right.
Yeah, I just introduced the tag management console. What can you do there?
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Anything else? Okay, fine, guys. So.